बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामु अलैकुम। आई एम प्रोफेसर हसन एंड यू आर वॉचिंग माई चैनल प्रोफेसर हसन हमायूं। यस्टरडे आई कंडक्टेड एन ऑनलाइन लेक्चरर स्टैटिस्टिक्स प्रेपरेशन सेशन इन विच मैनी मेल एंड फीमेल कैंडिडेट्स फ्राम डिफरेंट सिटीज ऑफ पाकिस्तान पार्टिसिपेटेड। आई विल डिस्कस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड इसेंशियल क्वेश्चन ऑफ डैट सेशन विद यू पीपल बिफोर स्टार्टिंग टूडेज वाइटल एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट लेक्चर। आई रिक्वेस्ट एवरी वन सब्सक्राइब टू माई चैनल, लाइक एंड शेयर माई चैनल एंड क्लिक द बेल आइकन फॉर द नोटिफिकेशन ऑफ द नेक्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट वीडियोज। लेट स्टार्ट। क्वेश्चन नंबर वन इज इन द बर्नौली डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन द रैंडम वेरिएबल कैन टेक द वैल्यूज 0 एंड 1। देर इज ओनली वन ट्रायल एक्चुअली। 0 इज फॉर द फेल्यूर एंड 1 इज फॉर द सक्सेस। इट कैन ऑल्सो बी रिटन एज 1 माइनस क्यू एंड इट कैन ऑल्सो बी रिटन एज 1 माइनस पी। अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट। देन स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ द बाइनोमियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फॉर द पेपर, डिपेंड्स ऑन ए नंबर ऑफ ट्रायल्स, बी नंबर ऑफ सक्सेसेस, सी बोथ। एक्चुअली द स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ द बाइनोमियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन विच इज अंडर रूट एन पी क्यू, इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन बोथ नंबर ऑफ ट्रायल एज वेल एज प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ सक्सेस। देन नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज इफ एन इज इक्वल टू 1000 एंड पी इज इक्वल टू 0.5, then the binomial distribution is symmetric, positively skewed, negatively skewed. As we know that when p is equal to 0.5, then the distribution will be symmetric. Next question is, in binomial distribution, what is the variance of x over n? We know 1 over n square, variance of x, and that is npq over n square. These will be cancelled. PQ over N will be the correct option in the exam. Next question is, for binomial distribution N is fixed and P is 0.5, then there are four options. Poisson distribution will be the good approximation to the binomial. B, Poisson will be the bad approximation to the binomial. C, positively skewed. D, negatively skewed. Dear students, the question is N is fixed and p is equal to 0.5. when p is equal to 0.5, then it can never ever be positively skewed, it can never be negatively skewed, so two options are omitted. Then the next one is, when p is not very small, then it can never be, we cannot say that Poisson is the good approximation. What is Poisson? When n becomes large and p becomes very small, approaches to 0, then we move towards the Poisson. Here p is 0.5, it means that the correct option is Poisson will be the bad approximation. A very important concept. Next question is, necessary and sufficient condition of hypergeometric is, the correct option is sampling without replacement. Next question, a binomial distribution may be approximated by Poisson when n approaches to infinity, p approaches to 0, becomes very small, and mu is constant. Next question, normal approximation to the binomial distribution when n is large and p is approximately normal, approximately close to 0.5. Next question is, when binomial approaches to normal, when we have np greater than 5 and nq also greater than 5. A very important question. Next is, p is equal to 1/4, q is equal to 3/4. What will you say about the binomial? As it is less than 0.5, it is 0.25. It means it is positively skewed. Next question is, which of the following is the most suitable, reasonable condition for the binomial approximation to the hypergeometric distribution? A very important question. There are four options, small n and capital N are given. Capital N is given, it is 800, and small n is 50. It is option number D, and that is the correct one. Actually, The question is, when binomial is the good approximation to the hypergeometric? There are four options. Small n and capital N are given. It is the correct one. Why? Actually, we have learned that there is FPC factor. Whenever small n is 5%, more than 5% of the capital N, then we ignore that factor. N minus N over capital N minus 1. We will have to check it. It is what percent of 800? We will have to calculate 5% of 800. 40 is the answer. It means small n is more than 5% of the capital N. So we will have to ignore that FPC factor, and it is the correct option. When binomial is the most reasonable approximation to the hypergeometric distribution. A very important concept. Next question. Mother of all the distributions is normal distribution. Next question. Stirling approximation is used when capital N is infinitely large. Next question is, Poisson distribution was introduced by Denis Poisson, French mathematician. It is also called law of small numbers and the distribution of rare events. A very important one. Next question is, in Poisson distribution, the range is 0 to plus infinity. If x follows Poisson distribution, y also follows Poisson distribution, then x plus y will also be Poisson, and mu of z will be equal to mu of x plus mu of y. The mean of the new variable will be equal to the plus of the means of these two variables, and there is the converse property also. If it holds, it means that mu of x plus mu of y, if equal to mu of z, then x will follow Poisson, y will also follow Poisson distribution with two different means, mu x and mu y, and the converse was given by Raikov, R-A-I-K-O-V, a very important one. Next question is, if x follows Poisson, y also follows Poisson, then x given x plus y will follow binomial distribution. Next question is, in Poisson distribution, mean is equal to variance, k1 is equal to k2 is equal to k3 is equal to its parameter mean. Next question is, the shape of the Poisson distribution depend upon its parameter lambda. Next question is very important. Bivariate normal distribution has how many parameters? It has 5 parameters, mu of x, mu of y, sigma x, sigma y, and sigma xy. Next question is, maximum ordinate of the normal distribution is at x is equal to mu, and if I put it in the formula 1 over sigma 2 pi under the root e raised to power minus 1 by 2 x minus mu over sigma whole square, if I put mean is equal to x is equal to mu, that whole portion will be omitted and the answer will be 1 over sigma 2 pi under the root. Next question is, we know that mu plus minus sigma contains 68.2% of the values, 27. Mu plus minus 2 sigma contains 95.45% of the values. Mu plus minus 3 sigma contains 99.73%. It is called empirical rule, a very important one. And dear students, in normal distribution, the range is minus infinity to plus infinity. But the practical range is 6 sigma. How do we get it? Actually, the minimum value will be contained by mu minus 3 sigma and mu plus 3 sigma for maximum value. If I subtract them, mu plus 3 sigma minus mu plus 3 sigma, 6 sigma will be the practical range of the normal distribution. Then a very important question. We know that quartile deviation is equal to, in normal distribution, 0.6745 sigma. It is also called probable error, and Q over sigma is equal to 0.6745. Both are probable error, and quartile deviation is also equal to 2 by 3 sigma. Then asymptotic property of the normal distribution is that the curve never touches the x-axis. Next question is, we have two normal variables x and y, both means will be added. We have the property of mu x plus mu y and variance of x plus variance of y. Next question is, x follows normal distribution, y also follows normal distribution, then x over y will become Cauchy distribution. If I have y over x, that will also be Cauchy. X follows normal, y also follows normal, then the ratio of x and y will be Cauchy distribution. The ratio of y over x will also be Cauchy distribution. Next question is, geometric distribution is also called waiting time distribution. Next question is, in negative binomial distribution, if we need one success, it becomes the geometric distribution. In binomial distribution, trials are fixed, number of successes are not fixed, whereas in negative binomial as well as geometric distribution, trials are not fixed, number of successes are fixed. Next question is also very important. We know that in normal distribution, the MGF is, movement generator function is e raised to power mu t plus 1 over 2 sigma square t square. If I put mu is equal to 0 and sigma square is equal to 1, I have e raised to power 1 over 2 t square. That is the MGF of standard normal distribution. Next question is, negative binomial is also called Pascal distribution. It was introduced by mathematical person Pascal. Next question is, negative binomial distribution is always positive, a very important. Next, geometric distribution is also called distribution of memoryless property. Next question is, in discrete distributions, geometric distribution is the only one which has memoryless property, and in continuous, exponential distribution is the only one which has memoryless property. Then mean and variance are equal in Poisson distribution, and mean and standard deviation are equal in exponential distribution. Next question is a very important one. Discrete multinomial follows chi-square when n approaches to infinity. Next question is, the sum of square of all the standard normal random variables will become chi-square distribution. Next question is, if z follows normal distribution and y follows chi-square, then t is equal to z over under root y over its degree of freedom, a very important one. Next question is, in t distribution, if we put degree of freedom is equal to 1, it becomes Cauchy distribution. Next question, t distribution in which degree of freedom is infinity, it follows standard normal distribution. Next question is, x follows chi square, y also follows chi square, then x over its degree of freedom over y over its degree of freedom will be f distribution. Next question is, n is equal to 1 in chi square is extremely J-shaped, and when the degree of freedom approaches infinity in chi square, it becomes normal distribution. Dear students, at the end, I request everyone must comment on today's lecture. Assalamu alaikum.